Okay, hands up if this happened to you before. You solved your shot in SynthEyes, you aligned your scene, and you lovingly placed your reference geometry in there. Then you work on your scene a bit more, refine your solve, and your reference geometry is all over the place. Let's fix that. In this quick tip, I'm going to show you how you can use lock points to make sure that all the alignment you did actually stays in place. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris FX. Let's take a look at lock points inside of SynthEyes. As you can see, I already solved this shot and placed some geometry in here for the ground and the pillars. If we shuttle through this, we can see that I was maybe a little bit overambitious with already putting so much work into setting up all this geometry, because we still have an HPix of above 2 and also some pretty nasty spikes in our error curve mini view. But I've got an ample amount of trackers, so we'll let SynthEyes calculate the lens distortion and we'll also run the cleanup trackers dialog. I will set our solve mode to refine and hit go. Once SynthEyes is done, we've got some good news and some bad news. The good news is that our error value is down considerably. The bad news is that our geometry is nowhere near where it should be. So what happened? Let me undo and redo a couple of times. There's a substantial change in the position of each tracker, but our geometry actually stays in place. How can we force SynthEyes to keep the scene in place while still refining the camera? Let's rewind a bit to the moment before I did run the cleanup trackers dialog. I'm going to switch over to the coordinates tab. Do you see that? An empty constraints list. Now, depending on the method you use to align your scene, there might already be constraints here. And in that case, they might already do a great job in telling SynthEyes to not move the camera around each and every time. Or they are giving you a hard time. If it is the latter, you can clear the constraints list by right-clicking and choosing Clear All Constraints. Now it is a blank slate, the same thing you would have had if you did your manual alignment in the 3D room or aligned to a geometry. What we want to do now is select a couple of trackers to serve as lock points. Think of these lock points as little anchors for your scene. They will tell SynthEyes to solve the scene in a way that after the solve, this point will live at exactly these coordinates. To set one up, select the tracker and on the left-hand panel, turn it into a seed point. That way, we get that tracker as an item into our constraints list. And there, we've got two sets of coordinates: the locked position on the left side and the solved position on the right side. Funnily enough, the XYZ coordinates for both the solved and the locked position are identical. But if we change its behavior from unconstrained to locked point, it'll always stick to these values when refining the scene. In the camera viewer, our point will now also have an additional light blue cross identifying it as a constraint. For good measure, up here, I will turn seed off again. One lock point will not suffice, so let's select some more. Something between 6 and 10 trackers will be ideal. You want these to be pretty low error, and we can see that error if we take a closer look at the error curve mini view down here, while we've got that tracker selected. And why do these potential lock points need to be low error? Well, it would be a real shame if we set these up and on our next sweep of the cleanup trackers dialog, we just accidentally delete them. By holding down Shift, you can actually select a bunch of trackers. But if you do that, always take a look at the error curve mini view, and if you accidentally select one with a high error, keep holding down Shift and click it again to deselect it. The error curve mini view will live update with an amalgamation of all selected trackers. With those guys selected, I repeat the process. Turn into seed points, change to lock points, turn seed off again. Back in the solver room, I'm going to once again run the cleanup trackers dialog. And when refining the scene, I once again get a very offsetted geometry. Obviously, Christoph, because you forgot to turn on the constraint checkbox. Yes, but it's not quite as simple. When the constraint checkbox is not checked, SynthEyes will first do a solve or refine and then apply the constraints by translating, rotating and scaling the scene into place after the solve. In a lot of cases this works and it gives SynthEyes a little bit more flexibility to come up with a better result. On the other hand, if constraint is checked, SynthEyes will use the coordinates of the lock points as hard truth before it solves or refines anything. So let's hit go again, but this time with constraint checked. Now our geometry sticks into place. But it will limit SynthEyes flexibility, might require more iterations on the solve, and if there are conflicting constraints, it might make the scene unsolvable for SynthEyes. In that case, it is worth revisiting the constraints you have set up in the coordinates room and choose different, better ones. If you pick your lock points with care and diligence, then they are a great way to lock your scene into place and a huge asset in iterating your work. If you want a more in-depth look at constraints and the coordinate system inside of SynthEyes in general, check out our SynthEyes Essentials course linked below. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris FX, and I will see you in another video.